वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज सोनिया हियर फ्रॉम ग्रोइंग क्राफ्ट। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ड्रॉपिंग इन। नाउ बिफोर वी स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो, प्लीज़ डू मेक श्योर दैट यू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू हिट द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू डू नॉट मिस आउट एनी ऑफ आवर अपडेट्स। ऑल्सो डू चेक आवर वेबसाइट www.growingcraft.com एंड लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। Now I have already prepped up my base with black gesso, so I have done it on my complete box, and now on my front side of the tree I'm going to have this beautiful DIY lace. Now for sticking this lace I'm using my Mod Podge. Just in case if you want to know how I have created this lace, you can check on my YouTube channel. I'll of course post the link in the description box, you can check that. Now this is a super easy and a super cool way to make your own embellishments with your POP, with your modeling paste, with your clay work, and they look absolutely fab. Now I'm going to have this pretty lace on the top and the bottom part of my tray, and once this sticks well, then we are going to move on to the next step. I was trying to add some more laces on the side, but then I felt that this is looking good and I really don't have to add too many laces because we are going to have so much on this tray that it's going to look beautiful at the end, I'm sure. I'm even sure that you have already seen the picture of the final product by now. Now, these are the MDF cuttings which I have used, and I have already prepped up them from the front part with the black color gesso. And now I am very quickly sticking these on my tray. Now, if you don't have these embellishments, you can go for any alternate. You can even make your own resin embellishments also and use them. They look absolutely gorgeous too. Of course, how to make the resin embellishments, I'll mention that in the comment section or the description box too. So this is one of the very gorgeous tray which I have made recently, and I was honestly very proud of myself when I did this. Now, just in case if you want me to create something beautiful, do let me know in the comment section what should I come up with, because yes, I have tons of ideas, but then I get confused that should I make this or not? Will you guys be liking this or not? So yeah, you guys can definitely help me out on deciding how this videos and what kind of tutorials you want me to see from myself. Okay, now I am just sticking some of the random flower cutouts. Now these are even also the MDF elements which you can have, and I have prepped up them with black color gesso, like I mentioned earlier. That's a very important thing, otherwise your colors are not going to get soaked to your bases really well. So now for sticking this, I am using my Mod Podge. If you want, you can definitely use other mediums too. It's absolutely fine. You can try out with glue gun. You can try out with your other liquid adhesives, and it's absolutely fine. So once I'm done with the sticking work, then we are going to move on to the next step. And once we are done with the drying process, then only we can do the coloring work. Otherwise, it's just going to smudge everything on the base and my embellishments are not going to stick really well at that point of time. So now this is one of the beautiful face mold which I am going to use. So I have done our DIY diffuser hangings also, and they look absolutely gorgeous with these cute little faces on the top of it. Now I'm just going to add a little more embellishments, and then I'm going to use my heat gun to dry this up completely so that we can do the color blending. Now I did my handle sticking work off camera, which I could not add up here for some reason. Okay, so now it's time to do some coloring work. Now I will be using all the chalk paints so that I can color this up. Honestly, on the laces I did this purple color, the chalk paint directly, and I was not sure if I'm going to have that, but it actually looked really good. So that's how I got an idea that I'm going to use this purple shade on my complete box. And mind it, I'm doing this only on the front side of my box. So here I'm using my fan brush so that I can just smudge it really well, just because my base is black color. So even if some of the parts are left out, it's absolutely fine, because anyways, we are going to do a lot of color blending on the top of it. Now, while actually shooting this, I was trying to see how beautifully I can show you the color. So I was trying to switch on the light, I was trying to switch off the light. So I was trying to experiment a lot just to make sure that you guys can see the colors beautifully. Now with the chalk paints, the best part is that once they dry out, they are completely matte. So usually with the mixed media, if you try your shimmer paints or your metallic paints with the matte colors, they look absolutely gorgeous and they pop out so well. So that's the reason I love using my chalk paints. And shades, what you are picking up for your base work is really important. And for blending this, I'm going to make sure that I do this really well. So for this, I am not going to use any of my brush. I'm just going to dab my green color with my fingers. Now, like I said, I was just trying to experiment a lot with my lighting so that I can show you guys that how beautifully my colors are looking, and they looked really, really, really pretty. So here is a very, very quick tip. Whenever you are doing this color blending technique, either you can have your stencil brushes, they work beautifully and amazingly, or you can try this technique with your fingers itself. What you need to do is you just need to have a tinge of color in your fingers, just like less than a drop. Smudge it well on your fingers and then just do a light dabbing. So how we apply the few of our cosmetics on our faces, that's how you have to do it. Very, very light. See, when it comes to the face makeup, we always say that too much of foundation is not good. In that similar way, too much of color when you are doing your mixed media is not good at all. So that's what I believe in. But if you guys have any other technique of doing this particular form of artwork, you can let me know. Now here on the intricate sides, because the elements what I have used are so intricate that I had to use my flat brush to make sure that it blends well. Now this looks gorgeous, and it's time to add a little more of green color on the edges, and then of course we are going to blend in the colors. But before each layer, we have to make sure that the previous layer have dried out completely. Now here I'm using a metallic color. Now this is a very bland metallic color and I absolutely love this. The reason is that it in a very subtle way, it makes sure that your elements are popped out really well. Now wherever you see me doing this color, you will realize that my embellishments, the base embellishments, whichever I have sticked, they are coming out so well. So that's the reason I love doing this color. And if you want, you can try out other colors too. This is the golden color which I no, this is actually the copper color which I have used. You can try out with different shades too. So yes, with the lights on, now you can see the proper color out here. I hope this is visible. Now of course I had to use a contrast color because I wanted to make this in a very nice rustic and very metallic way. So I thought of using my orange color. Now this is my orange shimmer color which I have been using for almost 3-4 years now. So this is from Crafter's Corner and I absolutely vouch for this one. I don't think they have these shades at Amazon, but I will try to link up, share the link of this metallic paint also. These are the shimmer paints, and this is these are like few of the shades which they had sent me when I was there in their DT team, and trust me, this one jar I have been using since then and they have never ever disappointed me. Never ever disappointed me. So yeah, that's a true a pleasure whenever it comes to your colors and your shades and the supplies, whatever we are using, because it's important to have something really good so that you can use them on multiple projects in different ways. Now once I'm done with my front side of my box, I am going to do the same color up on the sides also, and I will just do the orange color shimmer work, just the shading work on the sides, and this is just to highlight my sides and my other parts of my tray, and this looks gorgeous. Now I have already added my cotton thread handles to my tray, so I'm going to repeat the same metallic color to my handles also, and this is just to make sure that my tray looks in one theme, and it should of course get highlighted. As the Indian festivals are coming up, I am sure this is going to be a very cute little beautiful masterpiece for our decoration and for our planters, and yes, you can definitely vouch out for them. So yes, with this my tutorial is done. Just in case if you guys have any query, please do let me know in the comment section, and do let me know what else you want me to come up with so that I can post those videos really, really soon. And thank you so much. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel, friends. Take care. Bye-bye.
tracé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter.